Hey, this is Ryan of Happy Healthy Vegan. So many of you guys wrote to us on our Instagram and YouTube wanting us to check out this Australian TV show called Sunday Night, who recently did this feature piece called The Big Beef, Vegans and Meat Lovers Go Head to Head. So after watching this, I can see why so many of you guys wrote to us asking us to check this video out and make a response, because it's a very clearly biased video against veganism, even though it tries to portray itself as being some kind of objective journalism, which it's clearly not.
Animal rights activists have declared war.
Are you a mother?
How would you feel if we took you from your mother?
They were abused like this for an hour and a half.
Do you know those mothers cry? You've heard them many times.
Calling us killers, murderers, every name there that they could be calling us, they called us.
Diners are also under attack.
I see it as a form of terrorism.
The show's obviously trying to portray vegans as militants and make the general public afraid of us.
There's a growing vegan activist movement and they're becoming increasingly hostile. Oh, beef ribs, thank you, mate.
So we already see where this guy's bias is.
At the heart of it all is a philosophy that humans shouldn't impose their will on any animal, great or small.
What you're advocating is that all lives are equal. Humans, animals, all the same.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's going to make the world a complicated place.
Complicated? What in the world are you even talking about there, bro? I mean, what's so complicated about not eating animals, not using all the resources of the world to raise the billions of animals that are killed needlessly each year, and instead eat plants? It's not that complicated.
Animals are sentient, they feel pain, they have their own conscious experience, so they're not a thing, they're not an it, they're a someone, not a something.
Yeah, great job there explaining to the masses the basic moral principles about veganism. It's a moral ethical stance about not exploiting animals. And they further continue this discussion with Joey Carbstrong.
Some people that we've spoken to term it as almost a form of terrorism.
Interesting, that word terrorism.
Ooh, those spooky vegan activists are terrorists now.
Those activists are trying to stop animals from being literally butchered against their will. Okay, so who's the real terrorist here? Who's really being terrorized here?
But instead of answering that very real and poignant question from Joey, the host here instead spends an extraordinary amount of time trying to discredit Joey for having a criminal past.
Three assaults.
Yeah.
House arrest.
Yep.
6 months in prison.
Yeah.
A lot of drug use.
Yeah, definitely.
Can people trust a man with a criminal history like that?
Yeah, I mean, I don't want to live in a world where someone can't do wrong and then redeem themselves for it. I mean, I'm genuine in my heart. I mean, I've got nothing to hide now.
Wow, that really angers me. Why did they even have to ask Joey about his past? It's completely irrelevant. Are they trying to discredit him or discredit vegans? Make people afraid of vegans, like we're dangerous or shady, which Joey is obvious not. He's made mistakes in his past and has owned up to them. But the fact that he does have a criminal past has absolutely nothing to do with the facts about veganism. Anyway, it gets even worse now when they go and talk to this carnivore chef.
And boy, is she upsetting the vegans. Here in Austin, Texas, Jess is known as the hardcore carnivore.
Get in there and rip a hunk off. That's how well cooked it is.
Should we feel guilty about eating animals?
No. I think there's a responsibility to make sure that the meat that we're eating is being harvested humanely.
Wow, I had no idea that animals, like plants, were harvested. I mean, any vegan's just going to laugh, and any rational person, vegan or not, should laugh at this too. This is complete whitewashing of trying to make animal slaughter seem nice. It's harvesting. So I actually wanted to know, is this something real or is she making it up? So I found this animal agriculture business website where they described practices of humane harvest. It was pretty vague, but I found these 4 points, which are pretty laughable. They involved poking the animals with sticks or flags rather than electric prods, and keeping their areas open and lit rather than dark, because animals get nervous when they walk into a dark space to get killed. And keeping the noise low, machinery quiet, and make sure that workers don't shout or whistle at them. So that's humane harvest. Animals don't get electrically prodded, and they can see into the open and not be whistled at when they're about to be slaughtered.
This is probably their strongest argument. If you can get all the protein and sustenance we need from a vegan diet, wouldn't it be better that an animal doesn't have to suffer or die to sustain us.
Well, I'm impressed. Kudos to Bro there for actually asking a real question about veganism. Let's see how she responds.
I think that would be great, except that we can't.
What do you mean we can't? Of course we can.
You can't. So animal proteins are the only natural source of B12.
Completely wrong there. Animal protein has nothing to do at all with the production or synthesis of vitamin B12. It's a microbe that blankets the earth, and there are plenty of plant-based vegan sources of B12. Furthermore, much of the beef cattle raised for slaughter are deficient in B12 and are given B12 vitamins. So my point is, why kill an innocent animal as the middleman, eliminate the middleman, and take B12 yourself?
A core vegan diet needs so much either extra intake or added nutrients to actually be balanced.
Such BS. I've heard other anti-vegans like Chris Kresser make the same argument.
If you're a vegan and you're eating a vegan diet, you need to have a perfect vegan diet to be healthy. You need to know what you're doing in terms of supplementation and how to meet the nutrient needs that aren't being met through diet.
And this is complete nonsense. Let me show you the arsenal of supplements that I got to take to stay healthy as a vegan. Just a little B12 spray, a few times a week, handled. No animals need to die now.
Eating meat is part of a balanced diet. Every nutritionist in the world will tell you that.
Nope, another flat-out lie there. There are plenty of vegan nutritionists who will completely disagree with that statement. Furthermore, you have the American Dietetics Association, who say that vegan diets are healthful and appropriate for people in all stages of life. And then when you think that things could not possibly get any worse, they talk to Sean Baker.
How long have you been doing this?
27 months.
Okay, so more than 2 years, meat only.
And Sean is living proof. While his blood test shows slightly raised cholesterol levels, otherwise, he's in great shape.
This is just completely crazy how they just glossed over his LDL of 141, which, as it shows here on their own show, that he's in high risk for heart disease. And furthermore, they just completely ignored the rest of his blood panel, which I covered last year, and it's not that great. He has a fasting glucose of over 126 on multiple tests, which indicates diabetes. His hemoglobin A1C is just 2 points away from diabetic. He's on the upper end of pre-diabetic. And his testosterone levels are those of a person in his 90s. So why do these show producers believe that Baker is so healthy?
This kettlebell is 80 kilograms. This is a 200 kilo deadlift.
Oh yeah, I forgot Baker's rule there. If you can deadlift 200 kilograms, that completely negates all your poor blood work. Well, if a 200 kilogram deadlift is impressive for these show's producers, how about a 209 kilogram clean and jerk done in competition here by vegan athlete Kendrick Ferris, who was the only male to qualify and compete in the Rio Olympics. Pretty convenient though of these show's producers to not talk to the vegan lifter here. So what do you guys think? Share in the comments here. Do you think this was a fair and unbiased piece of journalism? Did they present the vegan side as well and as strongly as they did the meat-eating side? Share your comments down below. I'll be curious to read it all. And until next time, guys, remember, it doesn't suck being vegan. And before I go, I want to give some shoutouts to our latest supporters on Patreon, Ryan Oates and Elizabeth. Thank you so much. Your contributions really help us to be able to make shows like this on the reg. Round.